Every morning I wake up to requests for food, for medicines, for connections to hospitals, to oxygen beds. I have got emails from a refugee camp saying, ma'am, we need food again. I have got emails from villages in Bihar and Assam of the most vulnerable women and children, Dalits, Adivasis, inside red light areas, saying, Didi, we need food. It's all run out. Imagine not being able to afford a paracetamol or a Tylenol when you have fever. Imagine not having food in your tummy to be able to digest the medicine. So I'm trying to make sure this situation is minimized. And I have these human chains which are in place of mill owners, factory owners, shopkeepers, transporters, students, community mobilizers who are once again willing to step in to help. So I'm coordinating all that through virtual WhatsApp groups and making sure that we start our food drive again to make sure that every last girl who is in a brothel, who is in a migrant worker slum, who is in a refugee colony, gets food and can live to perhaps go back to school when the government figures out what to do with these children. Group known as denotified criminal tribes. They are formerly nomadic people who were labeled as criminal tribes under British colonialism because they resisted the British Empire. They had their own manufacturing and trading skills. And because they were so pushed into criminality by being jailed again and again, they ended up in intergenerational prostitution. And many of them basically live off selling things on the street or performing on the streets. And now nothing is possible, so they have nothing. And I got a heartbreaking message from one such group living in the Kathputli colony of Delhi, saying, Didi, we feel so ashamed to ask you for food again. You kept us supplied with food the whole year. But this is Ramzan. We have nothing to eat. We are 30 families. Can you send us food one more time? I felt my dignity that I had to get such a message from somebody who was a street performer, who had a skill, and who had to ask me for food. There are more than 230 million children in India who have been affected by COVID, but out of these, even 6 million children are never going to go back to school because they are now affected also because of lack of food. And that has been caused by either the death of a parent or the loss of job of a parent. And they have to enter the workforce. And I'm trying to make sure they get fed and they study as long as I can. I had a lot of partners for my 1 million meals food drive for the entire 2019-20 and up till March 2021. The same people have reached out to me saying they want to help. So Chef Vikas Khanna has said he wants to help, as has the India Gate rice mill owner, as have people from all over the world, foundations, individuals who have been calling nonstop, concerned about India and saying, what can we do? Ashley Judd is there, Gloria Steinem is there in America. And of course, there are European friends, including survivors of trafficking and prostitution from as far away as South Africa and Ireland who have made donations. And then there are people in India. There are students from Ahmedabad University, from Tata Institute of Social Sciences, from Jadavpur University, who have already emailed me saying, tell us what we can do, we'll do anything. And they are already preparing social media messages and spreading the word. I can't do everything that a government can do, but I have stopped thinking about what I can do, and I'm doing what I can.